This video shows you how to get started with software asset management. Software asset management provides visibility and control of software licenses throughout their lifecycle. With SAM, you can manage software assets efficiently by answering important questions about ownership, purchasing, and usage. The Software Asset Overview consolidates dashboards into a single, high-level view to provide visibility into the many different areas of SAM. To help you manage your software licenses and processes, this page shows important information such as publishers and products out of compliance, true-up costs, software spend, and more. These can be filtered by publisher or product. Also accessible from the overview is the Activity Center, which displays alerts like import errors, normalization suggestions, or catalog requests, as well as notifications generated by the system. Show Help displays a badge indicating the number of help articles available for the workspace. Click it to expand and display links to relevant articles. Icons at the left give quick access to license usage, license operations, software asset analytics, the success portal, the renewal calendar, and content lookup. License usage displays the compliance status on various publishers' products that you have installed or subscribed to. Each publisher card shows a color-coded compliance status, true-up cost over licensed amounts, and potential savings for that publisher. We can pin any publisher card to the top of our license usage dashboard for quick access and visibility. Clicking on the publisher card gives us an in-depth view of the publisher software with widgets that are specific to the publisher. We see a full view of the compliance status for this publisher software. Clicking on any of the software products gives us more information. License metric results gives visibility into our software compliance position by showing licenses owned, licenses required, and available licenses, all in a single view. Also accessible from the product summary is removal candidates, which lists users who use the software infrequently or not at all, such as employees who are no longer with the company, entitlements, and remediation options, which provide various ways to remediate or correct non-compliant software. Also available under license usage is the reconciliation tab, which shows your reconciliation history, the removal candidates tab, and the reports tab. With license operations, we can view all your license and discovery models managed by SAM. Here, we can create, edit, delete, and view details related to software entitlements and software models, and view discovered software for engineering applications, engineering license servers, license consumption, and more. We can use software asset analytics to track the performance and view analytics of our installed software. From here, we have direct access to the SaaS overview, which provides a single view into all SaaS-related KPIs for products like Microsoft Office 365, Adobe Creative Cloud, and many more. The optimization and savings dashboard shows us potential cost savings for software assets. Here, we also see recommended licensing optimizations, such as reclamations or downgrades, for third-party software. Through the success portal, software asset managers create success goals and activities related to those goals to get an understanding of how the SAM application works in the environment. Success goals such as onboarding new software, reduction of licenses or process improvements, and the activities related to them can be created here. The overview provides visibility of projected savings, past and upcoming success goals, projected success savings by category, completed success savings, and completed success goals. After they're created, success goals can be reviewed and monitored. Success activities can be assigned to people in assignment groups across your organization, helping to facilitate collaboration with stakeholders to help manage software goals. The Asset Executive Workspace provides visibility into critical KPIs for SAM, as well as for hardware asset management and cloud insight applications in a single combined view. Here we track the progress of ITAM with widgets that can be filtered to obtain more customizable results. We can filter by product, domain, or both product and domain. Returning to the software asset workspace, the renewal calendar shows all on-prem and SaaS contracts that are eligible for renewal. Here we have a visual reference for contracts that require immediate actions and can trigger contract renewal flows for all expired and soon to expire contracts. Content lookup is a repository of software and hardware product data from multiple tables, which provides an intuitive user interface for searching. Here we can view a list of all software products, publisher part numbers or PPNs, hardware products, and hardware model numbers. We can also search for specific software, PPNs, and view additional details related to software, such as versions, product lifecycles, and more. For this search, we were able to locate a specific software program. We can dive deeper to view information about the product, like discovery maps and versions, software product lifecycles, and PPNs. With all these features, software asset management serves as an IT solution that optimizes software spend, reduces compliance risk, and automates software lifecycle workflows. It also bridges the gap between departments and products within your organization. For more information, see our product documentation or knowledge base, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.